Jimmy Mhlanga is facing up to 1 year in jail for sharing a person's COVID-19 test results on WhatsApp. According to Section 39 of the Health Act, a person's health status can only be disclosed if the user consents to the disclosure in writing, if a court order or a law requires disclosure, or if non-disclosure of information represents a serious threat to public health. It's actually a level 8 offense if Mhlanga is found guilty and can face up to 1 year in prison, or a fine, or in a worst case, both. Econet is working on a bundle for religious sects to allow them to buy data for their congregants. Pastors wishing to get access to this service can email to chiedza.chagaka@econet.co.zw with an Excel database of their congregants' phone numbers and the single bulk payment. The list should have a minimum of 50 church members and can go up to an unlimited limit. Church members on this list will then be able to buy bundles at a reduced price through the church's merchant code or the church's assigned number. Sasai announced that it now supports voice and video calling of up to 20 people. This is an effort to make Sasai an alternative to online meetings and conferences, and comes after WhatsApp had too increased its limit from 4 to 8 voice or video call participants. A local company called Ixar Mobile is working on a smart feature phone. The phone will be powered by Kai OS and will be able to access popular services like WhatsApp, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter, and will be going for just $35. As soon as it is available, we will give it a review. Zimbabwe is no longer included on Global Survey on internet prices because of the unstable economy. The frequent price changes of data packages by local operators has made it impossible for Cable UK to provide an accurate report on internet prices in Zimbabwe, as by the time the report is released, it will be vastly inaccurate for Zimbabwe. The RBZ will be releasing new and higher denomination notes starting next week. These will be in $10 and $20 notes. The RBZ says the first wave will be just the $10 notes, with the $20 notes to follow later. The YouTube channel hosting Wadiwa Wepamoyo was hacked, as College Central, who are the producers of the show, reported on Twitter. The whole video inventory is no longer showing, and the channel itself has been renamed to Dave Ramsey. The hack also means the hackers now have access to the following of 60,000 that the channel had gathered, and also that College Central will not be getting any more revenue from their YouTube channel. A Zimbabwean show called The Cook-Off is going to be making a debut on Netflix. The romantic comedy, released in 2018 and screened in over 10 countries, gained awards that include the Best Feature Film and Best in First. That's all for the news this week. See you again next week.